that breath I just took and you just took and the next one I'm planning on taking is utterly dependent on the ecosystem being healthy. And without it, we're all gone. For a long time, it's all been about trying to make things a bit less bad. You know, trying to reduce the amount of water we use, the amount of energy that we use. But actually, I think we're past that point now. So now we need to move across to the positive side, where our buildings are an active part of the ecosystem. Imagine if we could start to turn buildings into carbon stores rather than being an emitter of carbon. We could have buildings that are generating more energy than they use, capturing every drop of rainwater that falls from the sky and using that instead of flushing it all away and trying to get rid of it. It's using local materials, reclaiming existing buildings. So now it's about, can we make the built environment actually help restore and regenerate the planet? I'm Dave Cheshire. I'm the Sustainability Director in Aecom. Aecom are a multinational building engineering and infrastructure company. So my role is working with developers and people making and designing buildings and trying to make them more sustainable and now more regenerative. That goal is this idea that the built environment becomes part of the ecosystem. We're completely divorced from it at the moment. Our buildings are currently built from materials that come from all over the world. They use huge amounts of resources. They assume that everything is being delivered to them, so the energy and water is just delivered at a cost, but without any implication, and the waste is just taken away. And we are just free to build whatever we want within planning and regulatory requirements. The impact of that is that it's not just a direct impact of building on that site, but it's also that huge shadow that buildings cast in terms of its massive supply chain. Imagine if rather than this very sort of bleak cityscape that it often is, we could bring nature into it and actually say, this has a value. So regenerative design is this idea that we're giving back to the planet and our buildings are an active part of the ecosystem. It's about providing what are called ecosystem services back to the planet. Things like purifying air, sequestering carbon into the ground or into our buildings, capturing the energy, capturing the water, and basically providing services that actually keep the ecosystem healthy. But there's lots of innovations in regenerative design. One example is one that Aecom worked on, which was the Green School in South Africa. It reclaimed materials, it used lots of very local materials to construct. It's covered in photovoltaic, so it generates its own energy, it stores its own energy. It captures water. It's actually even part of their education process that they understand regenerative design. And then the whole landscaping is just bursting with biodiversity and local flora and fauna. But then all the way through to some really cool stuff around nature-based design. So using sustainable drainage systems, using green roofs, green walls, and then even some ideas around microbial fuel cells. So what they do is they clean up the wastewater, so sewage, out of a building. The microbes actually eat all that, and that's their food, basically. And what comes out the other side is clean water, and you can return that to the ecosystem. But as a byproduct, they also generate energy. There's lots of practical examples of regenerative design. Can we co-involve with the rest of the planet? Or are we always going to be a self-imposed sideshow, but one that is dominating and actually doing damage to the planet? In Costa Rica, there's an area called Sweet City. There, all of the pollinators, the trees and the plants have citizenship. So they're actually valued at an equal level to the people that live there. which is just such a radical idea. So we're in a linear economy at the moment. So in a linear economy, we dig stuff out of the ground, you use it for a while, and then we chuck it away and it becomes waste. It comes back to haunt us. So the circular economy is trying to move away from that linear model to one where we're closing those loops. This idea that at the moment we just glue everything together and weld everything together in a way that we can't really get those bits of the building back in the future. We can actually deconstruct our buildings rather than smashing them to pieces. Then we leave this brilliant legacy for future generations to do urban mining. We've, you know, dug out those resources. Why can't we reuse it? This whole question around how we fund this and how we make this work and stack up is a systems level problem, because we don't value the ecosystem. We get fresh air for free, and it's got 21% oxygen in it, and yet it's excluded from our economic system completely. So I think we need to find ways to start to value all of those services as part of our economic system. I'm already seeing big clients set themselves targets about improving the biodiversity net gain. We move from a state where I walk into a design team and there'll be a slight rolling of the eyes and go, oh no, Dave's company is going to cost us loads of money and it's going to be a pain, to actually being, what else can we do? What else can we do to make our building better? After spending nearly 30 years doing this, I think I saw a massive change. I think we're going to have to move even quicker. I think it's very easy to blame the system, but actually, you know, we are the system. We just have to do this. We have to look at ways to protect and restore the ecosystems that are basically our life support system.